A very good day to all of you. Computer Shiksha is supported by. In the Paint 1 module, you have all learned quite a lot already, like line tool, text tool, rectangle tool, color 1, color 2, fill with color, thickness of the line, color palette, copy paste, undo, redo, oval tool, etc. We will begin today's class from the part of the first module where we had finished earlier. Firstly, we will revise some of the commands we have learned earlier, like copy, paste, cut, undo, redo, and select. In today's class, all of you will revise the oval tool and will use the color box 1 and color box 2. You will also make some pictures using the oval tool. You will also be using the copy paste, cut paste, undo and redo command. Now, all of you open the MS Paint file in the same way as you were opening during the Paint Module 1 classes. Can you tell what is undo? By using undo, we can remove our mistakes one by one from the paint sheet, or we can say that we can erase our mistakes. Do you know which shortcut command you will need to use for undo? The shortcut command for undo is Ctrl plus Z. In order to see how it is used, all of you first draw 3 ovals and then press Ctrl plus Z, and you will find that all the three ovals get deleted one after the other. If you face a problem in using undo, then you should watch the video and learn how undo is to be used. Practice the use of the undo option by watching this video. So to practice undo, let's first draw 3 ovals on our drawing sheet. For this, we need to select the oval tool and drag it on our paint sheet. As is being shown in the video, by dragging, we are making 3 ovals. Now, to undo these ovals, you can use the shortcut command Ctrl plus Z. So to use that, you have to keep the Ctrl button pressed with one finger of your left hand and then press the Z button with your right hand finger. And you will see, as soon as you do the first Ctrl plus Z, the last oval that we had drawn gets removed. Do it once more, the second last oval, and then do it one more time, the third last oval also gets removed from our paint sheet. So this is how you will use the undo command. Do you know what is redo? Redo is the exact opposite of the undo process. While with undo, we delete one by one any line or text, with redo, we bring back the same line or text one by one. Can you tell for redo which shortcut command will you use? For redo, the shortcut command is Ctrl plus Y. For this, you need to keep the Ctrl button pressed with the finger of your left hand and then keep pressing the Y button one after the other till the redo process is completed. This will bring back any line, oval or text that you had earlier deleted by using undo from your sheet. Now, all of you practice the use of redo. Just as you had removed the 3 ovals from your sheet by using undo. Now bring them back by using the redo command. If you have any doubts about using redo, watch the video and learn from it. Let us now watch this video and see how we do redo. As you had just used the undo command to remove three ovals from your paint sheet, now you can use the redo command. To use redo, you have to keep the control button pressed with one finger of your left hand and then press the Y key on the keyboard using your right hand. As soon as you press control plus Y, your first oval which had been removed in the end comes back. Similarly, you keep pressing control plus Y second time, the second oval comes back, and you press control plus Y another time, the third oval comes back. So this is how you can use redo command. Do you know why we use copy and paste? Copy means to get an exact replica or copy of something which is on your sheet, like any drawing, like an oval or any text, etc. For instance, if you have a picture of a house on your paint sheet and you want to make more copies of the same, then you will use the copy paste command to do the same. Do you know what is the shortcut command for copy and paste? In MS Paint, for using copy and paste, the commands are as follows. For copy, you will use Control plus C, and for paste you will use Control plus V. Let us now learn how these commands are to be used. Before you use the copy command, you should know what object, like a line, an oval or a text, you want to copy. For this purpose, all of you draw a line or an oval on your paint sheet. Note, take care that while doing copy, you keep the control button pressed with the finger of your left hand and press the C key once. If you face a problem in doing copy paste, then you can watch the video and learn from it. Let us now watch this video and learn or practice the use of copy paste once again. So if you want to copy something, you first have to have something on your paint sheet. So we are selecting the oval tool as is being shown in the video by bringing the pointer there and clicking. Bring your pointer to the paint sheet and by dragging, draw an oval. Once you have drawn this oval, take the pointer to the select option, click on that, and from the options which are available, select the rectangular selection by clicking on that. Now, since you want to select this entire oval and you want to tell the computer that you want to select this entire oval, keep the pointer such that you can drag a rectangle on top of this entire oval. Once you do that, your computer knows that this oval has been selected. You can see these dots on the sidelines, on the borders. Now, to just do copy, you can use Control plus C, which is shortcut for copy. You will not see any change happening, but when you do the paste command, the shortcut for which is Control plus V, you will see that a copy of this oval gets pasted on the left top of the screen on your paint sheet. Now you can pick it and move it according to your choice to a place where you want to place it. You can see that when you bring this oval close to the first oval, the first oval is not visible to us. To make this correction, you need to take the pointer to the select option, and click on that, and then click on the transparent selection option. As soon as you click on the transparent selection, you can see the first oval also, and now you can move the second oval and place it where you want it. If you want another copy, you will again do the paste command using the shortcut Ctrl plus V. Once you have another copy, the third copy appearing of the oval, you can again pick it and move it to where you like to place it, as is being shown in the video. One more time, let's take another copy of the oval by doing a Ctrl plus V, which is the paste command, and move this also here in our drawing. So this is how you can use copy and paste. You will now learn about cut paste and know what happens when you use the cut command. When you use the cut command, you remove or delete any text or drawing that you don't want on your sheet at that place. For example, if you had drawn a line and then you don't want it at that place on your sheet, then you will use the cut command to delete that line. However, before you use cut, you will need to select that line so that your computer knows that that line or text or drawing has to be cut. Now, all of you drag and make an oval on your sheet which has color filled inside it, and then cut the lower portion of the oval. Let us now watch the video and learn about using the cut paste command. Let us watch this video and practice the use of the cut option. So in this video, we first need to draw on our paint sheet. We are selecting the oval tool, and then we also select the fill option. So we take our pointer to the fill option and select solid fill. As is being shown in the video, we select the solid color, and then let us see what happens if we select color 1 and color 2 both to be the same color. So we are selecting color 1 as black, and color 2 also we are selecting as black. Next, bring your pointer to the drawing area and drag an oval. So this way you have an oval. Now you want to cut the bottom portion of this oval. So take your pointer to the select tool and select the rectangular selection option. From the box that appears, select the rectangular selection, and now position the pointer such that you can select the bottom half of the oval that you have made. Like this. And then you use the shortcut command for cutting, which is Ctrl plus X. But as soon as you do Ctrl plus X, you see that this entire portion of the oval and the lower portion, which was the rectangular selection, has all become black. For this, we need to select the color 2 as white color. So let's undo this, what we have done just now, by using the undo command. And then we select color 2 and make it white, as is being shown in the video to you. We are selecting color 2 and then making it white. Now once again, we take our pointer to the select option and select the rectangular selection, and then select the bottom portion that we want to cut. Now use Ctrl plus X, and this portion will be cut from the drawing. As you can see in the video, this is how you can use the cut command. If you want, you can now paste it anywhere on your sheet by using Ctrl plus V as the paste command. So, have all of you understood how and why these commands are to be used? If you have a doubt, then you can ask again, because in this module, we will use these commands to make pictures. Look at this picture in front of you and say, what is this called? Yes, this is a picture of a face. Can you tell how you will make this picture? In order to make this picture, all of you will make use of the oval tool, color 1 and color 2 and the fill option. Then, to make the eyes, you will use the copy paste command and you will use the cut command to make the cap. Note, when you use color 2, then before you use the copy or cut command, you should make the color 2 white. Now go ahead and make this picture. If you have any doubts while making this picture, then watch and learn from the video about making the same. Let us now watch this video and see how we can use different tools to make the picture of this face. So firstly, select the oval tool as is being shown in the video. Then select color 1 as green, or you can select any other color of your choice. And also select color 2 and make it also green. So both color 1 and color 2, we are selecting the same color. Go to the fill option and select solid color option from there. Now bring your pointer on the drawing area and drag an oval as is being shown here in the video to you. Now we need to cut the bottom portion of this oval. So for doing that, first select color 2 as white and then take the pointer to the selection tool. Click on that, left click, and from the options which are available, select the rectangular selection. Once you have selected the rectangular selection, keep the pointer such that the bottom portion of this oval is selected, because we have to cut the bottom portion. So we just drag the rectangular tool, select the bottom portion, it gets selected, and then you use Ctrl plus X to cut this portion. As you can see in this video, that portion has been cut. Now, we need to give this oval the shape of a hat. So we need to draw a small line at the bottom of this oval on both sides. So we select the line tool. The color is already selected as green, and we just draw this line here just below this half oval. And you can see that the hat picture is complete. Next, we need to draw the face. So we once again select the oval tool. Select color 1 and color 2. Again, we are selecting the same color. We are selecting yellow this time. Make both color 1 and color 2 yellow, as is being shown in this video. And then drag another oval here on the side. Now, as you know, we need to cut the top portion of this second oval, the yellow oval, so that we can make the face below the hat. For doing this, As you know, we have to make color to white. Take the pointer to the selection tool, select the rectangular selection, and then select the top portion of the yellow oval. Bring the pointer here, position it so that you are able to drag a rectangle to select the top portion of the yellow oval. Again, use Ctrl plus X for cutting this part of this oval. As you can see, it gets cut. Now we need to move this half oval, yellow oval, below the hat. So we select this because the rectangular tool was already selected, and then drag it to this place. Notice that some of the students might see that this yellow oval, when it's placed here, makes the green oval disappear, or portion of it is disappeared. That is happening because the transparent selection has not been selected, as is being shown in this video to you. So to make it correct, you need to go to the selection tool, click on that, and then click on the transparent selection. So select the transparent selection and then drag this yellow portion just below the hat, as is being shown in the video. Now the hat and the bottom portion of the face have been drawn. So now we need to draw the eyes. For that, again we select the oval tool and then select color 1 and color 2, both to be the same. We select solid fill, solid color from the fill option, and make color 1 and color 2 black. Right now we are doing selecting color 1 as black, and then we select color 2 also as black, and then bring the pointer to the drawing area and drag a small oval, black solid oval, to make the eyes. You can use the correct size. Now we need to copy paste this onto the face. So we'll have to first select the black oval that we have made, choose color 2 as white, and then once again go to the selection tool, select the rectangular selection option, bring the pointer so that you can drag a rectangle around this black oval, because you want to copy paste it. So use the copy command shortcut, for which is Ctrl plus C, and then when you use the paste command Ctrl plus V, you can see on the top left side of your drawing sheet that you will get another copy of the oval that you have made. You can drag it and place it such that it appears like the eye on the face. Once again, do a Ctrl plus V for the second eye and drag this also and position it such that the second eye on the face appears, as is being shown in the video to you. Now, next we need to make a smiley face. So once again, let's select the oval tool, and from the fill option, this time we will select no fill. And this time we select the red color to make the smiley face oval now. So the color 1 we are selecting as red, and then we just make this oval here. If you want, you can decrease the thickness of this oval boundary by going to the size option and selecting a different line thickness. Once you have made this, you just need to cut the top portion from this oval. so that you have the bottom portion of the smiley face. Again, we need to go to selection tool, select the rectangular option or rectangular selection, and then drag a rectangle on top of this final oval that we are making and cut this portion by using Ctrl plus X. Now you have the bottom portion of the smiley, and you can just drag this or select it and now drag it so that you can make the smile on the face like this. So this is how you can use various tools and the color palette 1 and 2 to make the drawing of this face. Now you have to make this picture on your own and then show it to your teacher. If you have any doubts while making this picture, then watch and learn from the video about making the same. Let us now watch this video and see how this picture of a little mouse is made. So to draw this picture, we first need to select the oval tool. So select the oval tool by taking your pointer there and using the left button on your mouse or touchpad. Then choose color 1, and we are choosing black as color 1, and choose color 2. We are using dark blue color as color 2, and then go to the fill option and choose solid color. Now bring your pointer to the drawing area and drag an oval here. You can see the color 1 is the outline of the oval and it is filled with color 2. Drag another oval here, a smaller oval here, as is being shown in the video. Next, choose the line tool. Take your pointer to the line tool, left click on it to choose it. We already have color 1 as black, so we're going to draw black lines. You can draw a line here as is being shown in the video and another line here slanting downwards, and then join the second line to the first oval that we had drawn. Watch in the video and you can do the same. So we draw here. Next, we need to draw now the eyes. So we need a small oval. So we first select, make the color 2 also as black. Both color 1 and color 2 are black now. So we'll be making a solid oval when we have selected the oval tool, which will be of black color. So since we have to make the eye, we just position our pointer here and drag a small oval here, as you can see. Then make another oval here, just at the tip of the nose or the mouth, and also drag a third oval, black oval, in this area as is being shown. Now we need to copy paste this and position it where we want it. So let's first select the color 2 as white, then go to the selection tool and select the rectangular selection option, and then select the last oval, black oval, that we had made by dragging a rectangle around it. Now to copy, you can use the shortcut command Ctrl plus C. You don't see any change happening when you do copy, but when you use paste control plus V, you see that an oval appears, a copy appears. You can drag it to make the feet of the mouse. One more time, do a control plus V so that you paste another copy, and then again drag this one also to make the second foot of the mouse. Now we need to fill color in the face area. So we go and select the option for fill with color, which is here as is being shown in the video. Change the colors, color 1 to dark blue, so that when we do fill with color, it is filled with dark blue. Bring your pointer here, use the left button on the mouse or the touchpad, and you can fill the face with the color. So this is how you can make this picture. We will end today's class here. All of you, close your file and then properly shut down your computer. In today's class, you practiced the use of the shortcut commands, and you also learned the use of the oval tool along with the use of color box 1 and color box 2. Computer Shiksha is supported by. Thank you.